Hey everyone. There's a new version of the AWS Certified Cloud Practitioner exam on the horizon. Naturally, the Digital Cloud Training Team wanted to give you a little heads up about the upcoming changes. Exam CLF-C02 will go live on September 19, 2023, with registration opening on August 22nd. All questions will be multiple choice or multiple response, and you will have 90 minutes to complete the exam. The passing score is 700 out of a possible 1,000 points. With a $100 price tag, the Certified Cloud Practitioner is the least expensive of all the AWS exams, but passing it will still earn you a voucher for half off of the price of any other AWS exam. There will be 65 total questions on the exam. Only 50 of those questions will be graded, and the remaining 15 questions will be used by AWS to gather data for potential additions to the question pool. However, during the exam, you will have no indication as to which questions are graded or ungraded. The new version of the exam essentially keeps the same four knowledge domains as the previous exam version, with some adjustment to their proportion of the exam questions. Security and compliance questions increase to 30% of the exam, and the cloud technology and services domain gets a slight bump of 1%. Conversely, questions about cloud concepts drop slightly to 24% of the exam, and questions about billing, pricing, and support are reduced by 4%. The new exam guide now follows the current AWS format, listing knowledge of and skill in items for each domain subtask. While the majority of the expected knowledge areas are similar to the knowledge areas in the previous exam, there are several important changes and addition that should be noted. The migration and business application job tasks are no longer out of scope. While cloud design principles were expected knowledge in the previous exam, the exam guide for the upcoming version suggests that there will be more emphasis on understanding those principles within the context of the AWS well-architected framework. Students must now understand or have knowledge of the following new areas: the benefits and strategies for migration to the AWS cloud, AWS cloud adoption framework, and appropriate migration strategies, AWS IAM Identity Center, credential storage and types of identity management, AWS Wavelength Zones and AWS Local Zones, database migration, memory-based databases, and database migration tools, edge services, such as CloudFront and Global Accelerator, use cases for storage classes, lifecycle policies, and AWS backup. But possibly the single biggest change found in the new version is the addition of AWS Artificial Intelligence and Machine Learning Services and data analytics services as a specific knowledge domain task. And of course, the ability to identify the use cases for a wide range of AWS services listed as in scope of the exam is expected. But fortunately, this is a foundational level exam. Knowledge of AWS services is expected to be only at a high level. There's no expectation that exam candidates implement or troubleshoot these services. Of course, since this is a new exam version, we are regularly asked many of the same questions. Do I need to recertify? AWS certifications are valid for 3 years from the date the certification exam was passed. Certifications are not invalidated with the release of new exam versions. You only need to recertify before your current certification expires if you're interested in maintaining that certification. Is there a lab component to the exam? As stated earlier, this exam only includes multiple choice and multiple response questions. When will the digital cloud training materials be updated to reflect new content in the exam? Of course, digital cloud training will be keeping our related course current, adding lessons detailing new exam content by the exam date. If I've already purchased the self-paced Certified Cloud Practitioner video course, do I need to repurchase the course again to access the new content? Absolutely not. All active subscribers will have immediate access to new content as soon as it is made available. That's all for now. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.